Hello there, welcome to another week in the garden. It's a nice sunny day today, not like yesterday. We terrible day yesterday with that storm Doris. It come roaring through. It actually took the felt off the top of this shed, but it was ready for renewing this year anyway, so I've put a patch on it and now I'll have to renew it this season. So we'll wait till the warmer weather. It's easier to felt in the warmer weather, but we won't. We've got a patch on. There'll be no rain coming in just yet. This week's far too wet to get out on the garden. It's absolutely waterlogged. We're going to set the tomato seed first. I'm going a little bit earlier this year and just hope that the weather holds. We might have to just get the seeds to break the surface in-house, then chill them down and put them out into the cool greenhouse and just cover them with a fleece if need be. Put in sun gold. Moneymaker, always put moneymaker in, and I put them outside. As you can see, it's only 50 pence for a big packet there. They will not let you down. And then we're going to do Roma, which is a plum type tomato. Diane asked for that one, so we'll see how we get on with that one. And then Shirley, which is a hybrid of the moneymaker, so it'll be a good tomato, that one. It won't let you down. We'll also pop these few sweet peppers in. These are King of the North. They should be all right this far north. And I really need to get some celery in, because last year was a bit late with the celery, and you want that with your salad. So let's get it up and get it growing. Tomatoes about 1/4 inch deep should be plenty for tomatoes. The temperature needs to be around the 60 mark. They need a high temperature to start them off, and then you can cool them down quite easily then. The pH is 7. The tomato seed, if you get the hybrids, you're probably only going to get 5 or 6 seeds, so be careful as you scatter them. This one, I think this isn't too bad. I'll just scatter a few on. There we go. I think if I can get one into that gap without it jumping. I'm not going to flick them this time, because they jump out the tray. So that's Roma. So as normal, squeeze the air out the packet, roll the top well. Roma is a plum tomato, and you can use it for your, it cooks and freezes well. A useful tomato, I think, to have. So we get this one in. We're only talking 1/4 inch. I have actually screen the compost this week to save doing it with that little sieve. It takes such a long time. And I think if we just level that up and don't squeeze it too far down tight, just it's more or less the weight of the wood just to level it. A ticket, we've gone to T labels now because it's easier for us to see. And there you are, just give it a. Now we're going to do Shirley, nice tomato Shirley. So we're just not going to get a lot. We'll just scatter what we've got, I think. You see, you don't get a lot of Shirley for your money. And same again. Just saves a bit of time if you skim it, if you sieve it ready before we start. And we just need a label, and just the weight of the wood, don't crush them down. Same again. Moneymaker. Yeah, I grow them outdoors every year and they're never any trouble at all. It's a nice tasting tomato. If you grow them in the soil outside, you get that real nice tomato taste, and this is one that will grow outside. There's hundreds of seeds for 50 pence. he says, if we can get them to float, we'll do it the posh way. Now I'll put plenty of these in because I will give them to friends, etc., and who then they can grow them inside or around. We'll just separate them in that little group there a little bit. I think that nowadays the tomatoes have been bred to taste sweet. This is one that still tastes of tomato, so I like this one. Same again. Scattering on. They're not a lot of problem. We'll just level that side, look, there you go. And that is Money Maker, this one. Label, one more, Sun Gold. I better pat this down because it won't be a lot of these. There's not a lot of tomatoes in the seed in this one. Let's pat it so we can try and get them to run. Might be one or two more in there. Oh, there you go. Three more. We just moved that one away. Look, there you go. Not a lot of seed for your money. Let's hope we can get them up. That's your yellow Sun Gold tomato. The Sun Gold's been bred with a high sugar content, and so it'll be ideal on your salads. It tastes lovely on your salads. There you go. So a little bit more here, look, just to finish off, just to neaten it up. I don't think there's actually any seed in there, but to make it look tidy. Not a lot of problem with the tomato. I think they used to be a problem, but nowadays, good quality seed compost, they're usually no trouble at all. Right, that's the tomato seed put in, four nice little trays there. What we'll do is I'll put the covers on and we'll pop them on a windowsill, perfectly all right on a windowsill, till they break the surface, and then we'll put some foil up until they're up. Then we'll harden them up a little bit and get them into that cold greenhouse and night cover them with fleece and they'll be fine. Now we'll cover them up and then we'll get these other seeds in. Use a spray bottle to water them and keep the bottle with them so the water is the same temperature as the plants. Two more lots we wanted to put in. We've put in a sweet pepper in as well as the celery. Now I don't remember last week where we was talking about pH for pepper seed needs to be a little bit more acid. So I put the probe in just to show you. It's doing a reading of 6 at the moment. I don't know if you can see it in this light. These are for the peppers. This is a pH of 6. If you can see on the monitor there, it's telling us it's 6. Peppers like to have a little bit more acid. Not a lot, but that will do nicely to set them off. Right, we'll put these peppers in. These are going 1/2 inch deep, so all the tray to the top, that's a good 1/2 inch, so put a few in. If they ever get here, here they come. There are peppers in here. Here they come. Think one more, perhaps one just there, just. Now remember, this is the acid one, so we use it in this, and this is going to 1/2 inch, so we're going to fill it to the top. And peppers need a little higher temperature than the tomatoes, so they will definitely have to go in the house, these. And we just a little bit, not a lot. There you go. We know now that they're about half an inch down. And we've put the label in. The King of the North, it's a green to red pepper. Very nice. We'll put the celery in. Last year we had the celery too late, so we're definitely going to try and get some earlier this year. Same temperature as your tomatoes, quarter of an inch deep. This is a hybrid, so there won't be a lot of them, so, and they are blank, so I shall do my best to just do a scattering across the tray, and I shall put them all in. If we can get them running, there we go. That's it. We use the different compost and quarter of an inch. We're using the John Innes compost. You can see that there's sand and everything in it. It's a nice compost to use. It's just only if you're using a different pH, I would just adjust it a little bit. But then it's only, as we said last week, it's just a bit of peat mixing in with it just to adjust it a bit. But that's it. Not too much fuss. A label. Celery, Starburst, F1. Very nice. We'll tray them. Now, I don't know if you can remember, but in the autumn we took the fuchsias and the geraniums and we cut them down and we potted them into some very gritty, sandy compost. Now, I've brought some of the fuchsias down to pot that are showing green. The geraniums are all showing a little bit of leaf, well, majority of them are, but they're not quite ready for bringing down for potting. Now, I've actually moved them out of this shed. They just overwintered in this shed and I've popped them in the cold greenhouse, and I've got a fleece in there in case it gets really bad. And they are just showing a little bit of leaf, but not quite enough yet to pop them on. But I thought we'd pop some of these fuchsias up. Now, these, I think the whole time we've had them overwintering, I've only really watered them in the last week or so, just to wake them up a little bit. As you can see, they're showing a bit of green. It's time to get them out of this sandy compost that's literally got no feed in it at all. We'll pop them into some peat free. I've added a bit of grit and a bit of Vitax Q4 to give them something to feed on, and we should be able to wake them up and get them going. So, as you can see, there is in virtually nothing and they're beginning to wake up. You've got some nice little bits of white root on there, look, so perfectly all right. Just have a look around, see if there's any vine weevil, grubs or anything in there that you don't want. There shouldn't be, because we checked them as we potted them. So we've got one. Nothing on that. Look at the lovely white roots on there. They really are waking up now. To say they've had nothing but this compost all winter, they haven't done bad. Even that one's waking up. Look, got some nice roots on it. Right, so we'll get them potted. I'll just pull this a little closer. I don't know if you can see this. It's a good gritty compost, so that the water will go straight through, and there's some Vitax in it as well. Now, these are not labelled, these are ones we've had in the courtyard, and if we've had them in the courtyard we must have liked them. So just a little bit. These will be watered and then put back in the cold greenhouse. It'll be perfectly all right now. As I say, if there's a good threat of frost coming, we'll put a fleece over them, they'll be fine. But they really are. Can you see how we've cut the root off, etc.? I'm not going to do any pruning to them or anything. I'm just going to get them woke up and get them growing now. See if we can get some nice big plants ready for a good flower display. That's two. We're going to do four. Perhaps just one more pot then. Lovely plant, look at that, full of root. All good that is. Very pleased with that. Don't over fern them. Nice and full so they can settle down. It'll keep the roots a bit warmer as well. So that's that one done. Right, here's the next one. It looks like there was just one big one in this pot. So we'll just give the little pot a little squeeze and then pull it out. As you can see, look, very, very little or anything in it. That's how dry they were. That's how you want to overwinter them. And then just shake the roots about. You know what we're looking for? Little white maggots that are eating the roots. Usually if you see lots of new growth, you know there's none in there, but we'll look anyway, because I'd like to show you one if you find one. No, that's clean. So we'll have him in a new pot. Nice big root there, look. It will fit, yes. Now if you can imagine that if this fuchsia is this big now, by the time we pot it out into the courtyard, it's going to be quite a substantial plant. So we'll put in the 1 litre to start with, and then we'll pot it into a 2 litre pot to really get it cracking, but enough in here just to wake it up. But I will do all the fuchsias we've got over the next day or so, and then pop them back up there. You know when your compost is right, because if you rub it through your fingers you can feel the grit in it, so it's always good. Right, so we need one more. Right, this one, this fuchsia is one that we must have liked. We've still got the label for it. It's Paula Jane and it cost £7, so it's quite an expensive plant. It's worth keeping through. So let's have a look what we've got. Just slide it out. As you can see, it's pretty dry. The geraniums will be the same as this when we take them out. But you know what we're looking for? I still can't see any. We did clean them very, very well when I potted them in the autumn, so I know there's not a lot in there. I'm looking for bits of root that look like they've been chewed as well, but there's nothing there. Best have a look. Check your compost as well. No, nothing there. It's clean. Nice and alive. The only another way to tell if your fuchsias are alive, I've explained one or two people this on the channel, and if you just scratch down, can you see we've scratched it there and it's showing green? That means that your plant's alive. Don't scratch it too much. It's not good to do too much and then just pop it back like that. But that tells you that your plant is alive. And even better, not to see any vine weevil, grubs or anything in them. That's lovely. There's a little bit of white root showing, so we know it's waking up. Right, looking at it, I think we'll pop that, because it's a big plant, we'll pop it into a little bit bigger pot. Well, here's the, I've got a bit bigger pot here. It is nice and clean and washed, so we'll use that. It's going to really take off. I'm not going to squeeze it into a little pot. After this length of time, we're not going to lose it for that. Just spread the roots out as you go in. Use this spillage compost first. And then, not too tight, give it a bang if you want. Right, and then we'll put this label in. $6.99. That must have been one of Diane's purchases, because I wouldn't have paid rent. She'll be pleased with that, because that, if you imagine it's, if it's that big now, before the summer and we put it out, it's going to be a huge plant. I'm not going to cut anything off yet, there's no big rush. So that's that one done. Also in the autumn, we took a few cuttings and we popped them in these little cell trays, and same again, overwintered in this shed, nothing special. As you can see, they're all the withers. There's a couple of syphinias there, look, they're a bit battered, but they will soon pick up. Couple of ivy leaf, couple of fuchsias, a geranium. I think that one's not going to make it, but that one will. I wanted to take one of these fuchsias up to make a standard, and I think we'll do this one. It's a red and purple one, that's all it says on this. What we'll do, we'll pop this into this 1 litre pot and start it, keep it going up for a stand. Any side shoots will take off. Let's see if we can get him out. Just a little press up. Anyway, it's rooted very well and growing, so that's going to make a good one. Just get rid of that. These were just cuttings taken in the autumn and more or less just left in these little cells. It's very gritty compost, so it looks fine. I did water them about a week ago, and that's fine, look, good root, no problem. And what we'll do is we'll pot it in there, and then we'll put a stick with it and maxi tapner until we get it up to maybe 30 inches, and then make that into a standard for you. So let's have him in. Just make a hole in the top so you can just pop him in. Oops. And just pop him in. That's it, that'll be no problem. And we'll take that one up for you to make a standard fuchsia out of that one. I'll just tidy up a little. This compost that we had, you can see how dry they've overwintered in it. This will be thrown onto the garden now, or in better still, it could go into the compost bins. There's nothing in it. It was just sand and grit and a bit of compost, that was the lot. Certainly worth remembering when you come to overwinter them again next year, what your compost needs to look like when you go to overwinter them, okay? Well, that'll be about it for this week. I've quite a bit of tidying up after Doris has been through. There's twigs and sticks and leaves everywhere to tidy up. But main thing this week was to get those seeds in, pot up these fuchsias. I will continue now with the fuchsias until I've got them all potted up. We will film the first loads of potting up of the geraniums that we've overwintered. They're still in the cold greenhouse yet, but we'll bring those down. These will go back up there now. Still some seeding to do outdoors, but the ground's far too cold. I think it's going to be a very wet spring the way we're setting off. I just hope weather changes soon. Next week, the onions that we started 3 weeks ago, they're about ready for pricking out now. So we'll get those pricked out into 9 centimetre square pots, I think, into some good compost and keep them growing. We need to keep them growing. Put them in the cold greenhouse. So I'll harden those up over the next week. So that'll be about it for this week from my shed. And hopefully we'll be out on the garden next week. I would like you to have a walk round with me before we start planting seriously, so I show you what we've been up to through the winter and especially the spring preparation. We'll see you next week then. All right, bye now.